Welcome viewers, I'm Mamta. Continuing chapter 2, Self and Personality. Today we'll be covering the approaches to understanding personality. Now, all the psychologists have given different approaches. Like the school of thought, we'll be taking on the major schools as the approaches to understand about personality. We have the trait and type approach, the first approach. Now, this approach basically tries to understand two aspects. One is about the type. Type talks about the characteristics which are clubbed in a group. If I talk about an extrovert, the extroverts are going to have common characteristics. Similarly, for the other type, they are going to have those characteristics. So, one type person cannot fit into the other type. That is the uniqueness. But yes, they are broad generalized categories. They are complete categories in which you have common characteristics. So, person fitting into one cannot fit into the other category because that category is different. That is a type approach. It attempts to comprehend broad patterns in the observed behavioral characteristics of individuals. The other approach is the trait approach. Now, trait, taken from the term personality, talks about specific characteristics. Now, these specific characteristics are again making the person unique. These are not general, they are not broad categories, they are very, very specific. So, it focuses on the specific psychological characteristics along which individuals differ in consistent and stable ways. A lot of times, these two concepts are asked in the exam, be it in the form of trait theory separately for a long answer, or be it a comparison between the two concepts. The third approach in the first category is trait, type, and interactional. Now, interactional approach says that situational characteristics play an important role in determining our behavior. Now, this again is an interaction of the person's genes, the genetic makeup, and the outside situations. Let's look at the type approach here. Okay. Now, we have the first category of type approach given by Hippocrates. Now, Hippocrates was a Greek physician who gave the first approach to understand the type of personality based on the body fluid, body humor. He talked about four different kinds of humor. So, he gave four names: sanguine, phlegmatic, melancholic, and choleric. Now, all of you would have heard of the Hippocratic oath that doctors take. That is what was the same person, Hippocrates, talking about personality here. Now, you just have to try and understand the four names. The characteristics as such, we will not be covering in detail. The second approach under the type approach, the second psychologist, the second person, was Charak Samhita. Now, this is the Ayurvedic version. In fact, let me tell you here that the type approach started long back. So, it first took up approaches which related the body aspects to the personality aspects, because that was the basic foundation by which people try to understand the way you are and the way you become. So, the second aspect under the type approach given by Charak Samhita, they talked about two aspects, the doshas, which are three in number, and the gunas, which are three in number again. Whenever you go to an Ayurvedic doctor, he always analyzes the three doshas in your body, which one is predominant, and the three gunas, that is the three qualities, again, which one is prominent, and therefore, he gives you the medication. So, again, type approach says here, you can only fit into one category and not the others. Okay, the three doshas, the three categories, you must have heard the names of Vata, Pitta, and Kapha. These are the three types of temperaments. These can form your temperament or your prakriti, the way you are, based on the three doshas in your body. The three will have different set of characteristics. Then we have the three gunas, under which we have the sattvic gun, the rajasic gun, and the tamasic gun. Now, sattvic gun are people who have the following characteristics. They are very particular about cleanliness. They are truthful, they are dutiful, they are detached, and they are disciplined. Now, people who are very pure in their thinking, who do not have any malicious intentions towards other people, do not have characteristics of jealousy, they eat very pure food, very simple food. Like whenever we used to see serials, we always understood sattvic characteristic as the rishis or the gods. That is sattvic qualities, very pure, very godly qualities. That's a quality, guna. Second is rajasic. Rajasic is people who do intensive activity, who have a desire for some gratification or sense satisfaction. They always look for sensory satisfaction. People who love eating food, people who love watching movies, people who love doing things through which they satisfy themselves, their needs, and they get pleasure. Again, dissatisfaction these people have. These people are a little jealous of other people's success. Material mentality. They are working towards materialistic gains, and these people have a little negative qualities. That is rajasic. Then we have the tamasic quality. These are like we had the sattvic as godly. These are little demonic qualities, extremely negative, the tamasic quality. Anger, arrogance, depression, laziness, and feeling of helplessness. Now, these people tend to react very fast. So, they are given in Ayurveda the kind of foods which are against their tamasic quality. Because if a person is hot-tempered and he is getting spicy food, it is going to enhance his quality of anger and hot-temperedness. Again, such people on the other extreme are in lazy and depressed category, where such people are low on energy and low on the mood state. Next classification, the third one under the type, is Sheldon. Now, Sheldon has given the category on the basis of the way you look, your body build, and related it to your temperament. So, personality was understood in terms of temperament. Now, he has given three categories. Let's look at it. Endomorphic, these people will be talking about their body build and their temperament. So, these people are fat, soft and round, and their qualities, they are sociable and they are relaxed. So, people who are a little hefty, they are normally chilled out and relaxed. They are very cool minded, very humorous. That is endomorphic. Second is mesomorphic, people having strong muscular body build, and they are very sporty and very adventurous. Third is ectomorphic. Such people are very thin and fragile, and they are very artistic and creative. Next is Carl Jung's typology under the type approach. Now, Carl Jung as a psychologist talked about two categories, introverts and extroverts. Introverts are people who prefer to be alone. They tend to avoid others. They withdraw themselves when there's a conflict. They are shy. Extroverts, very sociable, outgoing, they always look for company, they crave for other people. Next category and the latest category is Friedman and Rosenman's category. Now, they have given the concept of type A and type B personality. Type A people are very hardworking, high on motivation, self-motivated, workaholics, they take a lot of stress, they love to work on deadlines, and therefore they have problems like hypertension, like CHD, coronary heart disease. Type B is exactly the opposite. They are totally relaxed, totally chilled out, but yet they do their work perfectly fine. Now, under this, the last category is given by Morris, which talks about type C and type D personality. Type C people are prone to cancer. Now, let me tell you here that when we talk about the characteristics, you will relate certain characteristics to yourself. But don't put any fear in your mind, any scary thoughts in your mind that because I have these characteristics, I'm going to have this problem. It varies from case to case, but this is what research has proven. So, such people are very cooperative, unassertive. They do not say no to anybody normally. They always give in, very submissive, therefore they seem to be patient, but they have a lot of negative emotions in them. Type D personality, they are prone to depression because these people tend to take everything in a negative direction. They always criticize, they always say negative things, therefore they end up getting lonely and sad. That's about the type approach. Now, these approaches, when we compare them to trait approach, are extremely simple. And you might find that such a complex behavior of us cannot be explained by simple theories. Therefore, now we don't have clear-cut demarcations. We can definitely have mixed characteristics among the types. Let's move on. This trait approach is an improvisation. In fact, this was an antidote to the type approach because it talked about the uniqueness, the consistency, the characteristics of people, their strengths, and the combinations in which different categories appear together. Let's look at the first approach. Under the trait approach, we have the Alport's theory. Now, Alport was the pioneer in the trait research. He talked about how every behavior has a stimulus which is intervening and therefore there's a response. So, he talked about a stimulus response reaction, but he said that we have a lot of traits which are dynamic in nature, they keep changing, and he tried to identify different words to understand the differences in people. Now, he gave three concepts. His theory has three aspects. First is the cardinal traits. Now, when we talk about Mahatma Gandhi, we think of him as non-violence. When we talk about Mother Teresa, we think about helping instinct. This is cardinal trait, where your personality revolves around, your whole life revolves around these traits, and these are very, very general. And famous personalities have one higher generalized trait, which we call as the cardinal trait. Second is a central trait, which is a little less generalized, more specific. So, what you write in your CV or your resume, your letter of recommendation for going abroad, all those qualities are your central trait, which are important and central to your personality. It could be honesty, it could be hard work, it could be shyness. All these qualities are central to your personality. The last trait that Alport talked about is a very specific trait. It's like what I like, what I prefer. Do I like wearing Western clothes? Do I like, you know, eating mangoes? It's a very, very specific, and it's based on liking and based on your interest. Next theory under the category of trait is given by Raymond Cattell. Now, he talked about, you know, what he tried to do was he had a lot of traits describing personality, but obviously he could not use all of them to understand and measure personality. So, what he did was he tried to understand which traits are related, he linked them up, and he tried to cut down the number of traits. So, under honesty, let's say we have truthfulness, under honesty, we have other related traits. He tried to cut them down and he tried to have only 16 traits, which are the primary or the source traits. Now, he developed a test named as 16 personality factor test, 16 PF also we call it, which measures 16 extremes of source traits. Source is what is there in the base, in the nature. What it reflects as ultimately is your surface trait. So, if a person is aggressive, the source could be sadness or the source could be irritation. So, that is where we understand the source traits which are reflected in the surface traits outside. Next trait theory that we have is H.J. Eysenck. Now, he has developed two tests. He has developed Maudsley Personality Inventory, which measures the first two components, and he also developed, when he added the third component, the EPQ, the Eysenck Personality Questionnaire. Now, the first has neuroticism versus emotional stability. When you try and look at whether you are anxious or whether you are calm and stable, or you try and look at whether you are sociable, outgoing, or you are introvert. And then antisocial personality traits, where people were a little egocentric, hostile, and antisocial, which he called as psychoticism versus sociability. And the latest theory is the five-factor model, which was developed by Paul Costa and Robert McRae. It has five factors. Two factors are common, as neuroticism and extroversion. The other three are very general: openness to experience. Such people like to explore a lot, they like to try out new things. Agreeableness, they are very cooperative, like we have done. And conscientiousness, such people have a very high sense of guilt and regret. So, that is about the trait approach for today. We try to cover the type and the trait approach, understanding the difference between the two. That's about it for today. Thank you.